Hello, today we are going to make a body. Inflate a balloon leaving up to 2 inch flat tail. Squeeze the balloon to make it soft. Force the air inside of the flat tail. So the entire balloon is inflated now. I'm going to use this body to make Smurf. That's why I choose blue balloon to make legs and torso. And I'm going to use white balloon to make arms. Okay. I have prepared the blue balloon. Now let's fold the balloon in half. Hold both halves of the balloon in one hand about 6 inch away from the center of the balloon. That is the point where we have to twist. We twist both halves of the balloon in one move. This way we make 3 bubbles in one step. Alright, let's twist the bubbles. The loop of the bubble in the middle of the balloon should be big enough to fit 4 balloons through it. Take one end of the balloon and pull it halfway through the loop of the middle, the second bubble. Take the other end of the balloon and pull it in the same way, halfway through the loop of the second bubble. Fix bubbles in proper positions. We have made legs and torso. That is a back view. Bottom view, that is the front view. Let's put it aside for now. Inflate a white balloon leaving up to 2 inch flat tail. Prepare it in the same way as we did the first blue balloon. Squeeze it, get rid of the flat tail. Again we have to twist 3 bubbles and we are going to do it in almost the same way. There is only one difference. We have to make the middle, the second bubble, a bit shorter. Hold both halves of the balloon about 5 inch away from the center of the balloon. This time the loop of the middle bubble should be big enough to fit loosely just 2 balloons through it. Okay, we have made the arms. Now we have to assemble the body. Force both ends of the blue balloon halfway through the loop of the middle, the second white bubble. We put middle bubbles next to each other. White is on the bottom, blue is on the top. Keep ends of the white balloon at the back of the sculpture. Pull the ends of the white balloon one by one through the loop of the blue middle bubble. Keep the blue bubbles of the torso together. And the white bubbles go to the left and the right side of the torso. Congratulations, we have made the body. It is the back view. Here's the front view. We can shape the arms and the legs as we like it. We can use more balloons to make feet and hands. One more time, front view, back view, the top view, it's where we attach the head, right here between the blue bubbles, and the bottom view. Now we are going to use what we already have to make the simplest hands. Fold the white balloon about up to 4 inch away from the end of the balloon. Hold both sides of the fold in one hand about 1 inch away from the end of the balloon. Twist and lock 2 bubbles in one move. We have made the simplest hand. Make the other hand in the same way. Fold the other end of the white balloon. Mark the spot 1 inch away from the end of the balloon. Twist and lock. We can make feet in the same way. I would rather use different balloon to make the feet and then attach them to the legs, to the ends of the blue balloon. I use different color balloons for the body to make different sculptures. Red balloon to make Santa Claus body. Green color goes well to make bodies of elves, witches, monsters, aliens. And as I mentioned before, blue color is good for making body of Smurf. Here's an example of two-faced head. For the neck bubble from the top between blue bubbles of the torso. Congratulations, we have made the Smurf. This sculpture has two front views because of the two-faced head. Here's a front view of the monster. It is also the back view of the body. Here's a side view. There are not so many two-faced dolls on the market, which surprised me because generally kids love to play with this kind of transformers. Have fun and happy twisting.